Hello, my friend. Welcome to TubeU channel. When we start a design using the latest version, Fusion 360, the default configuration is parametric model. We can see the historical bar in the bottom area that records all your operation. You can review or revise this operation later to change the design. It is very convenient, but it is not the real parametric modeling procedure. And also, it is not the direct modeling procedure. Today, I will tell you the difference between these two main processes in Fusion 360 through a very simple case. Stick around, let's start. First, I will use a small free software called Parametric to monitor the system usage in real time. After download and install, run the program. It looks like this. Modify a leader using right-click mouse. Close most of the monitor items that only leave CPU and memory. Enlarge some figure area a little. Okay, let's start Fusion 360. In previous Fusion 360, when you start the program, there is an option that asks you which modeling system that you want to use. Of course, one is direct modeling and the other is the parametric modeling system. Now, this process is omitted that directly use the parametric modeling. If you do not use any variable parametric parameters when you're modeling, maybe you are just using the direct modeling method in fact. Or, I will call it the hybrid method. When you really want to use the direct modeling system, you can click this small icon and click Do Not Capture Design History. Then, you will not find the historical bar at the bottom. When you want to undo the operation, you just click Ctrl-Z as most Windows software use. When you get to the point and change something, the following operation will no good to use. You also can redo the operation by clicking this icon. The direct modeling system is an old-style modeling system that designs the model and changes the model directly. Since they do not record the historical procedures, the CPU and the memory of your computer can handle it much easier. My old computer can work very well using this method. Another merit is that it is very easy to copy parts from other designs. I use this method mostly now. My settings. Another method is that you just make a model design but do not close the Capture Design History function. Maybe the new Fusion users even don't notice this when they start. The merit is great since you can review or revise the design history at any time. And the more interesting is that you can modify it. The results may be not that permission as you expect. Anyway, if you have a powerful or lately purchased computer, I suggest you use this method at first. It is like old style, but you have the chance to correct some mistake or make a new design change at any time. Now, I want to tell you the real parametric modeling looks like. The parametric mean you should use some variable parameters in your design. At least one, I think. So first do this, open modify, change parameters and add one parameter. I use diameter as a test for this simple case. Define an initial number such as 4 mm. Click OK to finish it. Now it is a real procedure. Click the sketch icon to enter sketch edit mode. Select one plane as editing plane such as top plane. Make a sketch like this. Finish the sketch. Extrude the sketch to height of 8 plus D divided by 2. Make the M8 thread hole. Modify the thread. extrude another minus 5 minus the meshing divided by 2 height and combine them together. Now, select the front side and create a sketch. Make the sketch according to this diagram. Finish sketch. Make modifications to this motor. Select the side plane. Create a sketch. Make sketch according to this diagram. Finish sketch. Select another side plane of the body. Create a sketch. Make a sketch similar to above one. Finish sketch. Now modify the motor according to the side sketches. Now the body is almost finished. Let's see when the parameter change, what will happen. When changing the parameter to another number, the body will automatically change to the correct design accordingly. This is the rear parametric modeling knee. Finally, we add the screw and modify the body a little. Print them together. The simple garden fix is finished. There is still a little issue that to make the final modification. It should be done after careful arrangement. So, you can see the parametric modeling, you should plan everything before making the decision. And if you do everything right, then the future adjustment will be very easy. Also, you can see from the frame meter, it will use more CPU power to do the job. So if you have an old computer like me, sometimes it will take a very long time. Then, I will change to use direct modeling procedure to finish the job. Hope this video will give you some idea about the real meaning of this difference. If you haven't seen the video here, please do me a favor. Click the subscribe button and the small bell, so you will not miss an update. TBU China is waiting for you.